Hi, this is Bruce Maeder, and I'm the Technology Program Manager here at the Northwest AETC. And I have two things to show you today. The first is a free web-based piece of software that allows you to pull video from YouTube, and you can use it later in PowerPoints or in webinars. And then the second is the process on how to use that software. So first, let's look at how to use the software. So you open up your browser, and don't get distracted by this really fun Huffington Post article. Rather, you're going to go to www.clipconverter.cc. Again, that's clipconverter.cc, and this is some free software that allows you, or will allow you, to pull video from YouTube. To make your lives easier, I recommend that you select this browser add-on tab here, scroll down, and simply do what this says. Drag the toolbar onto your links, or drag this button, rather, onto your links toolbar. So let's put it here. Now, let's be honest, clip converter with an exclamation point, it's a little too long. I don't have time for all that business. So I'm going to call it Clippy, because it's more adorable. And that's it. So in terms of the software, you're done. Now, let's say you have some YouTube video that you want to insert into a PowerPoint or, say, for a webinar. And it just so happens that you're looking for something on telemedicine. A 31-second overview, if you will.
Resources in my rural area are sparse, and my patients experience complicated medical problems. Normally, I would
Perfect. This is exactly the video for me. So simply go up here to Clippy, push that button, and blammo, Clip Converter opens, and automatically the web address that is specific to that video on YouTube fills in here. Then you need to select the video type that you want to download, and you want this standard quality MP4. That seems to work well for me and my needs. The file name is simply the title that YouTube gave this video, so that automatically loads from YouTube. And then you need to select your conversion format. So this is sort of your output. MP3 is just audio, M4A is also audio, ACC, same. But I want MP4. That works well for all my Mac products, my iPad, my iPhone, etc. UPC users might need to use this, the Windows Media Video format. But again, I want MP4. And then there's a rudimentary sort of editing component where you can choose where to start and stop the video. So that's really the only editing piece that's within this software. And quite frankly, it's nice that it's here. I prefer to do editing outside of this program. But again, if you just want the first 30 seconds of a video or 30 seconds somewhere in that video, this is a great way to do it. Just deselect that. You can select the start and stop times and then click start. So then this will spool up and it's basically converting your file into that MP4 that we selected earlier. So yeah, it's taking a second, but you know what? It's a small price to pay for a shiny video that you can put into your PowerPoint. Then simply select download. And you'll notice that it pops up here and it's downloading to my desktop. That's it. Now that you have your file, you need to insert it into a PowerPoint. So you naturally open up PowerPoint and you have a slide all set and you simply drag your file into the PowerPoint and that's it, at least for you Mac users. PC users, this is a little bit different. So you would insert a new slide and you'd go to Insert, Movie, Movie from File. Of course, you have to remember what your new movie is called. And there you go, it's inserted. That's all you need. So we're done putting the video into PowerPoint. And now I'm going to show you how to put it into Adobe Connect. So the first thing you have to do, though, is you have to convert it from that MP4 into an FLV. So we have to do that. So the first thing you're going to do is open your browser. Oops, and you're going to go to zamzar.com. And this is a great free online file converting site. So we're going to choose the file, which is called Provider Experiences in Use here. And we're going to convert it to an FLV. And we're going to give it my email address, because it'll email us when we're done. And we're going to convert. Oh, it's almost done. Nice. So that should be in my inbox. And then we're going to take that file and put it into Adobe Connect. So then our next step is to upload the file into Adobe Connect. Now, trust me, everyone, I've already gone into my email account and I've gotten the file, and you can see it in the corner right here. So now I've opened up an Adobe Connect room, and this should be familiar with anyone, or familiar to anyone who's hosted an Adobe Connect session before. And so you're going to go to Share My Screen, but you're going to share your document. You're going to browse your computer. You're going to find that file, which is right here, Provider Experiences, and this is the .flv format, which is the one that Adobe can read. It converts it. Takes a few seconds. Blammo, there's your video, and look.
Resources in my rural area are sparse, and my patients experience complicated medical...
There you go. That's it. That's how you convert and then upload a video into Adobe Connect.